All right, everyone. So we're gonna work on a quick fun project real quick. I got an order for quite a few Spartan helmets that I make in the American flag style. These ones are actually gonna be battle worn, so there's an extra step with it. I cut these out on my CNC machine, but I used to, before I had the CNC machine, I cut it out on a scroll saw. So even if you don't have a CNC machine, this project is something you can do. Really, all you gotta do is go on, for especially for this size, all you got to do is go on Google, search Spartan helmet outline, whatever, Spartan helmet, print it out, cut it out, and then make yourself a stencil. And either you can just keep a wood stencil or you can laminate the paper, which is what I used to do, and then use that as a stencil every time and then scroll saw it out. But anyway, so what we're going to do with this, we are going to, we're going to torch it to bring out the wood grains. I use the Mod Podge method with my anytime I do paint, I use Mod Podge because it gives me very crisp lines. If I screw up, it's usually because it's my fault. But what I normally do is I'll torch it, I get the union ready, and usually you'll see this as I go, but we have blue, and my blue is that I use for my either my state outlines American flag style or this style is Atlanta Braves navy blue, and basically just because I had it for an Atlanta Braves order and it's pretty close to what I use for my flag, so I just go ahead and use that. And then the red is Bear candy apple red paint. But anyway, so let's get started. I'm gonna go ahead and torch these up, and we will get ready for the next step. So as you can see, we got them torched up. One thing I love about working with wood, and even if you make 1,000 American flags or 1,000 of these Spartan helmets, every one of them is gonna look different. I mean, you can look at these two Spartan helmets, which were cut out of the same exact board, and they both look different. One's got that little knot at the forehead area, and the other one's just got really thin grain, but both of them look cool in their own way. So even if you make a ton of them, they're gonna look different from one another. So that's what I tell everybody: when you buy a flag, the grain's gonna be different. The grain is like a fingerprint. So you're getting something different than the other people that bought a flag from me. So as you can see, just clearly just looking at this, these two look a lot different. Now we're gonna put the flag on it. So what I'd use is I take my stencil for the small flag. I'm gonna put it across, you'll see what I do. I'm gonna put it across and we will get started getting the union ready. See if I can find a pencil if I laid it down. Let me go grab a pencil real quick and we will get started. All right, so you can put your union anywhere. Make sure you guys can see what I'm doing. So you can put your union anywhere, but normally what I like to do is I like to go hit that point right at the top and come straight down and then across the left eye. So let's get it lined up. That looks pretty good. All right, let's go ahead and mark it out. Actually, that needs to come up just a touch. There we go. Slide it over just a little bit. There we go. Ah, if I can get it right. There we go. All right, so now we're left with a line for our union. Let's go ahead and do the other one. See if I can not be in your way while I do it. All right, there. Close to as straight as you can do it. None of them are perfect. Tell myself that all the time. None of them are perfect. All right. So there is your markings for the union. Now, what I do next is I'll tape it off. Let me get some, I gotta save that tape. Let me get some smaller tape. And we will get started. Yeah, I should have enough for that. Started on the union. Here we go. I'm running low on tape today. All right, we're gonna tape off that line right there. Right here, and if you can tell your line's a little bit slanted, which that one is, now is where you want to try to get it even. That looks pretty good. Let me do one across like that. Let's see. Right there. Like I said, if you notice that it's a little bit uneven, you don't have to stick to those lines, just giving you a general direction for it. But anyway, taped off that unit. Let's do this one real quick. Same thing. If you notice that it's a little bit uneven, go ahead and get it nice and straight. That looks pretty good. All right, so pretty happy with that. Now, so what I do is basically, you don't have to do this step, but I do it. I use Mod Podge. I don't know if you can see it right there. There you go. I use Mod Podge. I use the satin one because I don't want it to be shiny. I will now Mod Podge the tape lines. I actually do the whole area just to make sure I don't have any, like, it's all even. That's what I want. But what this does, it basically seals the tape to the wood. So you're not going to be able to, you're not going to have any bleeding with the paint underneath the tape. If you're using stain, you can't use this stuff because the stain will not penetrate it. That's why for my stake cutouts and my Spartan helmets, I use this and then I use paint. So let's go ahead and get started on that. Doesn't take a lot and it dries within 3 minutes, and you're ready to paint over top of it. So what I do is I kind of dab it around, make sure I get the corner really good, and get the tape lines first, and just put a little bit more right there in the middle, just so we're even, so it has an even coating of Mod Podge all the way through it. Go ahead and do the other one. Just a little bit. Don't want too much, because if you have too much, it's going to get under the tape, and then it'll be a mess. Go ahead and get that paint line real quick. Just get a little bit more in the middle. Remember, it doesn't take a ton. And then just smooth it out. You want to smooth it out, because if this thing dries and it's not smooth out, like, look, if you like leave just that right there, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little bit too much right there, you'll be able to see those ridges, especially when you paint over top of it. So you want to make it nice and smooth, get off any little clumps that you see, like that right there. And now all we do is wait for it to dry. Like I said, it'll be ready in about a few minutes. And then we'll go ahead and paint over top of it. All right. So yeah, it's been about 5 minutes. They're nice and dry. Now the next step really is just painting over the union. So, pretty self-explanatory. This paint right here is about on its last last leg because I've used up most of it. The rest of it's kind of dry, so it's almost like a paste at the bottom, but it still works. Oh, well, I spoke too soon. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah, let's try it. Looks all right. Now, one thing I didn't mention it is that when you're using paint, I'm going to throw this away after this, but when you're using paint and you're torching, you need to do all your torching work before you paint. Because with stain, you can do it beforehand. I mean, after the fact that you put the stain on. But with paint, it burns it. Or it doesn't really burn it, I don't know. It turns it gray. So you don't get the look that you're going for whenever you're using paint. So I always do all my torch work before. Sometimes I'll touch it up, but I only do it on the natural part of the wood without any paint. And that way I don't get that gray looking stuff. Let's see. I think I got enough in here. Kind of scraping the bottom, getting the stuff that's not dry. There it is. Getting the stuff that's not dried up. Shoot, with this stuff, I didn't need the Mod Podge because it's so thick. It's definitely not going to leak underneath it, but regardless. There we go. Scrape that off. There we go. Alright, now let's get those paint lines out of there. There we go. So, we obviously going to let those dry. May take longer than normal. Normally, if it's regular paint, it takes probably 20 minutes before I can move on to the next step. Now, if you don't have a CNC machine to cut out the stars, what you'll do is after, and I'll kind of show you that once we get the red stripes put on, but you can use that stencil, carve out your mark your stars on your union, and then just use a Dremel or whatever carving tool you choose, the chisel, and carve out the stars. So you don't have to have a CNC machine to do these. I did a ton of them before I got my CNC machine. But anyway, we're gonna wait for that to dry, and then we'll put on our red stripes. All right, so we got, this had plenty of time to dry. I'm gonna show you kind of the line you get when you do Mod Podge. Absolutely perfect. It doesn't go underneath the tape at all. So you get a really perfect line. That's why I love using that method. Let's go ahead and do this one. It's one of my favorite parts, is checking the line. Yep, look, that's perfect. And that one's perfect. There you go. Perfect lines every time. All right, so what we're gonna do next is I'm gonna go ahead and get, I use one inch painter's tape to make the stripes, and we'll go ahead and get started. Let me go ahead and grab the paint, and then I'll come right back, and then we'll get the stripes laid out. All right, so what I do for this part, like I said, 1 inch painter's tape, that's gonna be your stripes. They may be a little bit big for this, but that's just how I do it. So the first one I put down is in line with this one because it's obviously going to be a natural stripe. So I try to line it up as best I can. That looks pretty dang good. Push it down. All right, now what I do, make sure you can see it. Now what I do is I pull out a piece for kind of set, so I can set my... set each stripe accordingly, like at the same width, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Make sure you guys can see. Alright, so we're going to set that down. We're not going to push that one down because that one's not going to stay there. Alright, put that one down. This one is going to stay right there. Pull that one up. Now we know that these are going to be the same width because we use that in the middle of it. So let's go go ahead and get that part done as well. So I'm gonna turn this thing sideways. And just make sure you get it right up to the line. You don't want any white space showing. Right, that looks about right right there. Alright. Push that down. Alright. I don't stick to that. Alright. Barrier again. We're going to set it. Can you see? Make sure I do it in the frame. Alright. We're going to set that one right there. Not going to push down too hard on it. These ones don't have to be as long. Hopefully I have enough tape to do all this. Alright, we're going to push this one right up to it. That one's right butted up against it. Pull that one out. Same thing. I know we're going to be able to get one more up there. Put that down. And then put that one. That way you can see it better. Put that one right up to that one. Nice and even. Pull that one off. Now let's go ahead and make sure we're pushing down on all the paint lines. And we're going to do the same thing. Do the same thing to this one over here. Now, we're going to do the same thing that we did with the unions, and we're going to Mod Podge it. So let's go ahead and paint all the Mod Podge lines. These things don't stick together. Alright. So, like I said, it's the satin one. I don't like the glossy one for this one. So, don't need much, just enough to do the stripes. Alright, so that part is done. What I wanted to say is when you're painting on the Mod Podge, go in the direction that you're going to paint the stripes. Don't go that way, because then you'll have lines go this way that may show up. It may not, but I always try to keep everything flowing in the same direction that I'm going to put the paint on. So we're going to wait for this to dry. And once in, it shouldn't take that long. It should only take maybe 3 minutes to dry. And as soon as it's dry, we'll go ahead and get the paint on there. All right, so it is nice and dry now. I don't even think it took 3 minutes. I think it was pretty much a minute and it was dry. So like I said earlier in the video, this is Bayer Candy Apple Red. I don't know if you can see it. There we go. Candy Apple Red. I got this from Home Depot, and I use these on all my stake cutouts, that get the American flag and the Spartan helmets and the Punisher skulls. Basically anything that gets the American flag. All right, I got way too much on there. All right, so let's move these backs a little bit so they're in the shot a little bit better. All right. And this is pretty simple enough. I mean, don't really need to explain much of it to you. Just, you don't need a ton. I don't put heavy on and I keep on brushing until most of the excess is taken off. Because I want to be able to see the grain through it slightly, just to give it my look that I normally do. Now try to keep it from going over the edge, because like I said, you're not going to be able to torch it black, because it'll just turn gray. So you'll either have to sand it or just leave it. So it'll be nice and easy on the edges. Remember, we want nice, even brush strokes. This, like the other one, because it's pretty old, has gotten kind of thick, which is nice because it doesn't really run. So it's only going to go where my brush strokes go. And that's pretty much it. We'll do the other one. I'll do that in fast motion because it's honestly, obviously, just the same exact thing. These things will be dry and ready to go for carving in about 20 minutes, but I've got to go somewhere else. So it'll be a couple hours. So it'll have plenty of time to dry. All right, I'm going to make this in fast motion and enjoy. All right, let's go ahead and get these ready. I already pulled off the tape on one. You can see, look at that, pretty lines, beautiful straight lines. Let's go ahead and do this one, see if we did okay on this one. Now even with the Mod Podge, you can sometimes get a little bit of leakage, but majority of the time you get really perfect lines like that. You see, which one's next? Do this one. This one I did kind of heavy, so that one's good. And let's do this one and that one at the same time. And there you go. Perfectly straight lines with no bleeding underneath the tape. That's why I love the Mod Podge method. So what we're gonna do now, if you didn't have a CNC machine, you would take your stencil, obviously, trace out your stars, and take your Dremel and carve it. Pretty dang simple. I'm not gonna show you how to do that. I mean, you should, if you're doing this, pretty obvious which way you do it. Since this is a normal flag, my stars are going to be pointing up. Now, if this was a vertical flag where my stripes were going this way, my top of my stars would be pointing that way for the vertical flag. But since I do mine this way, it's just going to be normal pointed up stars. What I do for the CNC machine is I measure how wide this is at the widest point, how tall it is at the tallest point. I'll put that into my design software, put the stars on it that fit in there, and you'll see whenever I run it, there'll be some that don't even hit because it takes too long to try to figure out that curve right there and add that in there. So I just rather have them just miss and do some up here and maybe a little bit on the sides. But So, and that's how I do it on the CNC machine. And then once we do that, I'll go ahead and carve the scars that I do in it. We'll do the scars on it, and then it'll be ready to spray, and then it'll be ready to ship out. Alright, so we got these ready. Like I said, you see the stars are cut out on it. Use the CNC machine to do it. Now what we're going to do is I'm going to use my Dremel with the flex shaft with a 107 bit. And we are going to start doing the scars. Now normally, when I first started doing the scars, I would draw out the kind of the shape of how I wanted to do it. In each spot, usually I'll leave the union alone. I usually don't want to do anything on the union, just because I don't want to detract from the stars. So normally, and I switch it up a lot of times, normally what I like to do is do a big scar right here coming through, do a couple going on this side, a couple going right here, one coming from the top, something like that. But now, since I've done it so many times, usually I just wing it without drawing it out. So let's go ahead and get this one started. While I'm doing it, it's really loud. So while I'm doing it, I'll put on some music and we'll fast forward through it. All right, so with this one, I was kind of going back and forth whether I wanted to add more. I tried to do them differently from each other. This one's going to the same person, just as gifts for other people, so I wasn't too worried about it. But like I said, I like to kind of be different with each one. Now, after we're done this part, usually what I like to do is I'll take the torch and kind of give it some definition on the scars. So kind of give it a little bit of texture. See if I can do it while in the screen. See if I'm in the screen at that point. All right, there I am. Okay. So then I'll just take it and hit it with the torch a little bit on all the scars. Make sure I'm doing this in the screen so you guys can see. There you go. All right, here we go. Those are all that on that one. Do this one. Don't hit it too much, especially on the painted areas, because it'll turn it gray a little bit. So just hit it just enough to kind of give it a little bit of texture. Ah, there goes my, holding it upside down. There we go. Give it a little bit of texture. Like that. All right. And there she is. Right there. Let's see if I hold it like that, I can get it in the screen. Now all I do is spray it down, finish it. I'll torch the back of it, and then I'll add a little hanger at the back. And that's it. I'll show you the finished product once it's dry and everything on it. All right, I've said in previous videos that this is what I use for majority of my flags. I went ahead and sprayed it down for the first coat. We'll do probably about 4 or 5 more coats depending on how much shine I can get. Thing is dry. I mean, this thing dries in about 10 minutes. It's a little cold today, so it may not dry as quick. But it's definitely a lot quicker than brush-on poly. So that's what I use. That's what they look like. I already put the hanging hardware on the back of it, so that one's good to go. And once this is dry, I'll be able to ship it tomorrow morning. All right, there they are, all finished up. There's the hanger on the back. They're ready to get boxed up and out.